fire signs, Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. What's the deal? It's your girl Moniqua, and we are here for some What's Up With The Planets content regarding Mars being in the sign of Gemini, August 20th. You know we got the handy dandy notebook out. August 20th until October 29th. Now, y'all know how these go. You don't have to have Mars in Gemini, but your Mars could be in a fire sign, or your sun could be in a fire sign, okay? Or check your houses. So we got Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Aries is the first house. Leo is the fifth house. Sagittarius is the ninth house. So your sun or your Mars could be in one of those houses, and some messages in here could definitely resonate with you. Thank you guys for all the continued support. But please like, share, comment, subscribe, recommendations, tips, all that. I really appreciate it. To book a personal tarot reading with me, pricing and contact information is in the description box down below. All other info will be in the pinned comment in the comment section. Make sure that you are liking the video and subscribe to the channel, because it does keep me in rotation. Yes. So, a little bit of background. Mars in Gemini. So, Mars in Gemini is like anything can happen. Okay, because Gemini got them two sides, right? So, what comes with Mars in Gemini? Feeling like you have a full plate. It might be hard for you to focus during this time because Gemini, like I said, has dual sides. Okay, a little bit of a dual energy. And you know Mars is very, okay? Mars is just in drive all the time. It never parks, okay? So be careful about not being able to focus, having your mind on like a variety, like, yeah, on a variety of things, okay? Like, basically not focusing on what's important. You getting distracted too easily, okay? Or just unnecessary things are coming into play, all right? But the pros that come with this transit is that you could find yourself being a lot more adaptable, all right? It's like, you know, you're finding yourself being more open to certain solutions, creating certain solutions. You might find that your creativity is spiking during this transit, all right? That's the good stuff that come with it. So what we're going to do is pull one monthly Oracle message card, because this does happen, you know, over the course of more than a month, to see what the overall energy is going to be for the fire signs. And then we're going to do a spread. Remember, sun or Mars in a fire sign or the houses first, fifth, and ninth. That sound like a street up top. I was about to say in the Bronx. So I don't know if we got up top up in here, you know. The north. I love it. I love y'all lingo. So make sure I got everything. Okay. I don't want to forget nothing. So here, guys, how is this Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs, Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius, August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022? Some of y'all ready for fall? I was just thinking about it, girl. I am ready. Okay, you like summer? I mean, you can dress cute. Okay, have a little bit of skin out, but it's hot. I don't like to be uncomfortable. You know what I mean? Fall, the fits. Cause I'm feeling very bootish for fall and winter this time around. Very bootish. And other things. Let me stop. All right. So. Why? No, but five signs. Be prepared, okay? We're going to be facing some spiritual tests during this transit, okay? It could relate to anything, right? It's like I'm hearing, have you learned your lesson? Will you resist? Yeah. It's about things in regards to, like, have you learned your lesson in regards to some sort of situation? Will you be able to resist the temptation of something? Will you be able to discern the actuality of a certain situation? Wait a minute, where y'all going right now? What's on the bottom of that? But you got the cheat sheet. You got all the security codes, all right? New spirit. You got spirit guy on the bottom of the day. My condolences to anybody that has lost anyone, all right? But I do see that some of you guys, while I feel like you will be, you know, going through spiritual tests during this transit, some of y'all, there is definitely somebody around you, somebody that looks out for you, that will be leading you as well, like kind of dropping those crumbs, okay? Hansel, Gretel, right? No, girls, there's some witchy shit going on. Is there a witch trying to eat you? Girl, where is it going? All right, so, like, they got a little dark on us. Ooh, okay. Two of Cups. So some of y'all could be in a connection during this time, specifically with a water sign, but with the Two of Cups, I do see some of y'all. I do see some of y'all could be in a connection during this time. I'm also seeing with this Two of Cups is about love, bonds, right? Some of y'all will be receiving certain spiritual tests as it relates to bonds and the connections that you have with certain people, okay? Why can't it just be good? You know, so we got five and the Two of Cups, all right? Oh, Lord. Because this is a, what I said at the beginning of the reading, dual energy, right? Don't this, like, this looks completely opposite, okay? I don't know, girl. I'm seeing this in different routes, okay? I see some fire signs facing spiritual tests as it relates to their emotions and certain connections that they're in, all right? It's like having mixed emotions about being, I'm hearing, like, unsatisfied, dissatisfied with certain connections. Five minus two equals Three of Cups. So this ain't just about, you know, relationships. This is about friends, okay? The homies, right? And five plus two equals Seven of Cups. So having options, babe. Ooh, yeah. Fire signs, I see some of y'all dry. Not they did, girl. Never. But some of y'all, I feel like you could be very disappointed in certain options as it relates to love during this time. All right. It's like, but it's you're being tested in regards to this. You know, this gives me, it's like, okay, if you run across a certain connection to where it's not feeding you, whether it be physically, spiritually, emotionally, any of that, will you be able to, you know, walk away from this, detach from this, or will you just stick it out and just be like, hey, you know, girl, I'm not happy, but that's what it is over on this side of town. It's really weird, okay? It's situations like that I'm seeing happening as it relates to connections, relationships that you have with friends, okay? Could be family as well. Some of y'all, ding, 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 ding. Fire signs, there is somebody here outside of your energy heavy on the water, and it could be any water sign, okay? Because I got Cancer, Two of Cups. I got Scorpio, Five of Cups. Do I have Pisces? I do not have Pisces. Because even if I was to do five plus two, that only gives Seven of Cups, and that's another Scorpio energy. Some of y'all, there's definitely a Cancer or a Scorpio outside of your energy who I feel like... Girl, I don't want to get into this person's business like that, but it's here, all right? This person could be disappointed in some sort of connection that you're either currently in fire signs with a water sign, or there's somebody here outside of your energy who could be dissatisfied, unsatisfied. I'm not sure which one it is. In a certain connection that they're in. Let's pull these cards. Spirit guys, how's Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022. Yes. Ooh, shit. Damn it. Shit. Hold on. Don't let me pick. Okay. Well, so we got the Five of Pentacles coming out with the Fool card on the bottom of the deck. So, remember, overall energy is the Five of Pentacles. Fire signs, you need to be careful about taking a leap of faith in regards to certain situations that leave you, you know, in the trenches, in the dirt, right? I don't like that. Yeah, this could be making foolish mistakes. Okay. Fool card, Page of Cups, and the Eight of Cups. Some of y'all, I feel like, could be facing spiritual tests as it relates to putting yourself in dumb situations. Not even fucked up situations. This is dumb. It's like, why would you do that? Page of Cups here is the dick on your face, okay? Some of y'all, Fool card, Page of Cups, and the Eight of Cups. There could be some naive energy, dumb energy that I feel like with the Eight of Cups, some of y'all could be needing to walk away from as it relates to money, as it relates to stability, as it relates to your emotions. It's like, girl, what is you doing? All right? It's like with the Fool card, be open to, you know, taking risks. Be open to trying new things. But don't be out here looking like that. Girl, look at the clothes. There's a fish behind them. It's crazy. All right? Looks a little crazy. Just basically putting yourself in certain situations to where it's like with the Five of Pentacles, I'm hearing you lose, okay? Whether it be money, whether it be time, whether it be emotion. Spirit guys, how's Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? August 20th, okay. August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022. The mate, okay, Vietti. See, girl, you have no excuse. All right, so we got Magician card coming out. So some of y'all could have Mercury in a fire sign. With the Five of Pentacles and the Magician card coming out with the Two of Cups, some of y'all, there's no excuses to why you should be coming out as the Magician in the Five of Pentacles. Two of Cups. Yeah, girl, what is happening? Divine Feminine shouldn't be close to that. Okay, so homegirls, we might be talking to you. All right, but we might be talking to you. It's cool. Let's talk about it. All right, so we got the Two of Cups, Empress, and the Eight of Pentacles. Some of y'all know your worth. You know your value. You know, girl, if I was to be put on the shelf, right, what I would go for. All right, but some of y'all, I feel like it just give me energy. Don't invest your time, effort, and energy into things that ain't going to, you know, give you no... I heard ain't going to give you no grip. Okay, so I don't know if this is in regards to, like, opportunities, ventures, what you're going after during this time, all right? It's just with the Two of Cups, Empress, and the Eight of Pentacles, it's just like, you don't belong over here. It give me... You know, I hope this is going to sound bad, but I'm going to say it anyway. It give me the energy of, like, I don't want to say that, y'all. Like, you shouldn't be over there. Why you hanging out with those people? Why are you messing with these people? Okay, like... And I don't mean it in a foul way, because with the Five of Pentacles, these people do look a little bit, you know, homeless, okay, or in need, or unfortunate. I'm just seeing that Divine Feminine, I could be talking to you specifically, or whatever your steez is. This could be a certain type of energy that you're being in, or a certain environment that you're involving yourself in. Some of y'all, you don't need to be in the slums, girl, okay? As it relates to anything, not coming out with the Magician, it's like you deserve more. You're capable of more. You shouldn't be doing this, okay? So I don't know. This relates to, you know, anything, no fire signs, how you're treating yourself, how you're handling yourself, what you're going after for yourself, Magician, what you're creating for yourself, all right? Me stick with judgment. It's like, come on, girl, like you know you better than that. And I don't mean better than someone. I mean better than what you're doing, okay? I'm like, those don't go together. All right, like I said, some of y'all might have Mercury in a fire sign as well. Spirit guys, how is Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? August 20th until October 29th in the year 2020. It makes sense. So, we had two cards fall out upright, you know, the face up, eight-time down. But we had Three of Pentacles and the Knight of Swords show up. So, some of y'all, I feel like, need to stop being inconsistent. Knight of Swords and the Three of Pentacles, not taking a certain commitment seriously, consistency seriously. It's like definitely playing with the shit. Two of Pentacles to me is, you know, playing with the shit. Confirmations, 13-13 when I said that. But Knight of Swords is just like, okay, girl, is you here or nah? All right? It's like you show up to a job when you want to. Like, what? Like, girl, do you work here or nah? That's what they're saying. You need to stop that. You need to cut that out. Because the Magician is out here. The Magician don't belong beside the Five of Pentacles. This is like... It's just those situations where you see somebody in a certain place where it's like they don't belong there. They could be doing so much better for themselves, or doing so much more for themselves, you know? It's like, why are they in that position when they're capable, you know? This is somebody who knows how to create, knows how to manifest, you know? Spirit guys, how's Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? Okay. Hangman, Seven of Cups. Fire signs, I don't like it. I don't. I'm not a fan, but we need to hear it. So we got the Hangman coming out. Five of Pentacles, Magician, and the Hangman. So some of y'all, remember, overall energy is spiritual tests, right? Some of y'all are going to be facing spiritual tests as it relates to you procrastinating. As it relates to you procrastinating. As it relates to you giving up. As it relates to you doing... This ain't even the bare minimum. Six of Pentacles is the bare minimum. Five of Pentacles is like, you're not even trying. All right? Like, what are you doing? Hangman with the Magician. This is somebody here who knows what they need to do. Look, There's somebody here who knows what they need to do, but with the Hangman, they're like, but my hands are tied. Five of Pentacles, this for me is, you know, well, I don't have enough money, or, and it's like, well, you can make more money, Magician. It's like, I just keep hearing there's no excuses, fire signs, in regards to going after things for yourself, knowing your worth, knowing your value, knowing what situations you should or should not be putting yourself into. All right, Dad. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. All right. Seven of Cups is on the bottom of the deck. This could relate to unstable emotions about things, being all up in your head all the time. We need you working for Nike. Okay. Just do it. Magician. Spirit guys, how's Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022. Nine of Swords. Listen, I heard it, so I'ma say it. If you feel offended in any sort of way, that means that you know you could be doing better for yourself. Those are the bars. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, Nine of Swords with the Knight of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. Yeah, some of y'all, there could be some sort of fear that you're creating yourself. Girl, hold on. Is it? Sorry about that, y'all. There could be some sort of fear that you're creating for yourself, because the Magician card is out here. That with the Hangman, you're the only thing that's holding you back, fire signs. And you need to stop that. Knight of Pentacles with the Four of Pentacles in reverse. All right. It's like, why would you want to be a scavenger all your life? And when I say scavenger, I mean like not like a vulture or anything. It's like, why would you just want pennies? You know, why would you want to just be in the bushes all the time? It's like, why would you want to make things harder for yourself? Be in the slums, bro. All right? It's like, we want to move out of that. Sometimes we got to maneuver through it, but we want to move out of that. All right? Yeah. Five signs. Some of y'all, I feel like, are going to be facing spiritual tests as it relates to Magician card, making things happen for yourself rather than sitting on your hands with the Hangman, all right? Whether or not you're going to let Nine of Swords, the fear, the anxiety, the, you know, girl, it's giving why me, girl, not pity party Patty. I hope you didn't invite that bitch. I don't like her. All right, spirit guys, how's Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022. Five of Swords with the Empress. Divine Feminine, you keep showing up. Damn, that took a turn. I said at the beginning of the reading, though, to where it's like anything can happen. Be prepared for, like, some not even boomerang energy. It's like, I wasn't even expecting for that to happen. It's like, wow, that came out of nowhere. Remember how Mystic came out, and now we got the Five of Swords? Some of y'all have this going on outside of you. Empress, because this exact same combination came out earlier. Empress, Two of Cups, and the Eight of Pentacles. Some of y'all with the Magician card here, like I said, you are capable. It's like, how you going to talk about me, but I'm out here doing it? Magician, the Five of Swords, word on the street. It's like, you see me? I'm really in the kitchen. I'm cooking food for these hungry men's. My needy voice. Okay, I'm really out here doing things while you just looking at me. Like, that makes no sense to me. You won't talk shit about me, but you just be looking at me do shit? Like, weird. Some of y'all, I feel like that goes on around you. It's like there could be people who kind of are critical of you, a little bit judgmental of you, but they can't deny that they see you out here doing it, all right? Empress, Two of Cups, and the Eight of Pentacles. Some of y'all are in a very loving connection. Some of you guys are, I'm married to the money. Empress, Two of Cups, and the Eight of Pentacles. Right now, I'm dating my career. I'm really trying to get my shit together. All right, so that's where my focus is. And I feel like you could have some people outside you that I feel like that energy could be kind of like rubbing them the wrong way. So you might, you know, feel like you get a little bit of jabs here and there verbally, right? Or you just sort of feel like you feel this wonky energy from people to where it's like, wait a minute, you mad because I'm focused on getting my shit together or things are going good for me, girl? Makes no sense. My right hand itching for that paper. I'm riding around the city and I got my calculator. It's not my thing is actually my palm. Okay, so I don't know, some of y'all, yeah, it's like being handed blessings and I feel like you're doing something with it. Here we got Ten of Pentacles, Sun, Judgment. I'm not gonna do the reading like that, but Empress, Two of Cups, Eight of Pentacles, Sun card, and the Ten of Pentacles. Some of y'all, things are looking right, okay? Things are looking right your way. Judgment, High Priestess, Hermit. It's like a lot of you guys have grown. There's been a noticeable growth about you in regards to wisdom, all right? Not to say you ain't fucked up, because you have. I see it here. Some of y'all have gone through the fuck-ups, but it's like I've grown from that. And I feel like there could be people outside of you who maybe don't want that type of time, who upset with you for being on that type of time. Spirit guys, how's Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022? But like I said, on the flip side, we do have some other fire signs where it's like, listen, we gotta have a combo real fast. Close the door behind you, okay? Death is shit right here with the Two of Wands on the bottom of the deck. Some of y'all, I feel like there could be certain people outside of you who, it's like, see, that's why you shouldn't run your mouth, okay? Let me stop. But some of y'all, there could be certain people outside of you who I feel like have talked down on you, been critical of you, judgmental of you, talk shit about you to where they're going through something now. Nine of Swords and the Death card. They're scared of something ending. They're scared of losing something. But they kind of spoke this onto you. You feel me? But now I feel like it's happening to them. 21-12 when I said that, by the way. And now they're scared this shit happened. It's like, yo, with the fire signs, I didn't even realize this. With the Magician, the Five of Swords, some of y'all have some sort of energy surrounding you to where it's like people need to be careful about what they say to you or say about you, all right? Because it could, Mars and Gemini, it could boomerang on their ass. Like, wait a minute, it was you talking shit. It was that bitch over there. Row A9. I've been looking at her. She's been looking at me too. But some of y'all, it's that sort of situation going on to where either fire signs, you need to be careful about this, talking down, talking shit, spewing the bad juju towards someone, because that shit might boomerang towards you because of the energy that is surrounding this person. Remember, fire signs got the Spirit Guide card coming out, but this is also on the bottom of the deck. So like I said, fire signs, you need to be careful about doing this to someone, or fire signs, somebody here has done this to you and now you know. I don't know what the fuck that was. Okay. Some of y'all need to be careful about talking about doing something and you lose your opportunity. Nine of Swords, Five of Swords, and the Death card. Nine minus five goes Four of Swords, right? Be careful about, you know, chilling so much, laying back so much, you know, just being like, things are copacetic right now to where you miss an opportunity. Or Magician card, you miss your mark to really make something happen for yourself. Could be because of fear, could be because you feel like things are okay right now, but it's coming out of ego, because with the Five of Pentacles and the Five of Swords, like, who are you trying to, are you trying to convince us of that? Because it don't look that way. Spirit guys, how's Mars, Queen of Wands? Should I put this down? I guess so, because it's showing very heavy fire sign energy, specifically Leo. Sag, is you in here? I see Aries, I see Leo. I don't know where Sag is at, girl. You might be, you know, in the back row. All right, so we got Queen of Wands and the Strength card coming out. Five of Pentacles, Nine of Swords with the Queen of Wands. Oh, Sag, I was talking shit. There you go. All right. I don't like the way this look. Five of Pentacles, Nine of Swords with the Queen of Wands. Some of y'all need to be careful about, you know, letting fear kind of keep you like, it give me the energy, you know, in the ghetto. You know, I don't know if this relates to where you're putting yourself at, situations, how you're handling yourself, what you're accepting. But it's like being scared to either do better or being scared to do something because you're worried about what others are gonna say. So you stay in a certain energy. Queen of Wands, Five of Swords, and the Hangman. It's like you're trying to convince everybody else that everything is cool. And it's like, but girl, I mean, how do you feel? You know, it's that sort of situation, okay? I'm seeing this for Leo. I'm seeing this for Sag. I'm seeing this for Aries women, all right? Or some of y'all just need to be careful about fucking with a bitch who ain't got nothing. I'm just be honest with you. Five of Pentacles, Nine of Swords, and the Queen of Wands. It's, you know, I don't like what it's giving me. Because Because the Five of Swords is here with the Hangman. It's like, you know, don't deal with somebody that, you know, is scared to go after more for themselves, all right? Because maybe they don't know what they're capable of, their talents or whatever. But with the Five of Swords, they still be out here talking, you know, big money shit. Like, girl, I couldn't even call you little money, all right? No money. I'm going to keep that moving, though. We ain't even figured that out yet. So, guys, how's Mars in Gemini? Okay. It fell out face up. Not face up, booty up, so I'm not going to read it. Spirit guys, how is Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022. I was a little uncertain. Knight of Pentacles with the Six of Swords. Oh, there's another card on the bottom, but I'm going to put this Knight of Pentacles down. Okay. Ten of Cups with the Knight of Pentacles. Some of y'all are very like... nobody knows. Six of Swords on the bottom of the deck. I feel like there could be a lot of like, it's giving me commentary on your life. Specifically, it could be from family members. Ten of Cups. It's like, because you're very low-key or very private about what you're going after, what you're doing, fire signs, there could be some a lot of commentary about what's going on with you. Some of y'all, this is in regards to social media, people that you're related to, people that's just around you in general. Magician, Five of Swords, and the Knight of Pentacles. It's like, excuse me, I am so sorry. Because people aren't sure of what you're doing, just say anything, all right? I just feel like there's a lot of gossip going on about you guys, fire signs, because of how you move. Because of how you move, what you're doing during this time. Because it's like nobody really knows. Like nobody really knows everything that you're involved in, fire signs. So just be aware. There's some talks going around about you, okay? Some good, some bad. I'm just be real with you. That's that spirit guy showing up too. We got death card coming out in your reading. Some of y'all with the Five of Swords and the Nine of Swords. I don't want to say, you know, the spirits talk to you, but I'm just not going to say that because I don't want to seem crazy. But you do have the Magician card out in your reading too with the Queen of Wands. Some of y'all, what are you into? You got Queen of Wands, Magician, and the Death card. Okay, now some of y'all, this is just having a very strong power of speaking things into existence. Like I said, people speaking ill will on you and they don't even know if they're casting a spell on themselves. All right, it's kind of like fire signs. You might have a little bit of a mirror energy about yourself. It causes this to happen, but what you be out here doing, fire signs? Your spread looks a little interesting. Queen of Wands, Magician, the Death. See you guys. Last card. How's Mars and Gemini transit affecting all fire signs? August 20th until October 29th in the year 2022. Ace of Wands with the Seven of Wands. You got a... I'm sorry. You got an ace out with the Magician. Ah, I love seeing it. So, I see something new here being manifested during this transit. All right. Definitely some new beginning, but this could be a new way of doing things. Queen of Wands, Knight of Pentacles, and the Ace of Wands. This could be you operating in a different capacity. What you're going after, how you're pursuing things during this time. It's just like y'all going to be moving different during this transit. All right. Yeah. Hangman, Death card, and the Ace of Wands. A lot of you guys are going to be urged to stop prolonging a certain transformation with yourself. Or you're going to realize that some sort of stagnancy was a transformation for you. It's like you need to get out of some sort of like Five of Pentacles energy, some sort of lack energy in order for you to Ace of Wands being this new energy. Some of y'all are being urged to do this. Some of y'all are going to be going through this, all right? Resist. Listen, fire signs. I feel like during this transit, you got options. I already saw that. But I don't really feel like that is the focus right now. You ain't got no cups out in this reading, okay? I don't really feel like... unless you are already in a loving connection, okay? Unless you are already in like a good connection. So I'm going to need to be careful about certain love offers coming in during this transit. Knight of Wands, Strength card, how you're handling your emotions. Knight of Wands, Strength card, Knight of Cups, Queen of Cups, and the Seven of Wands. Resist. Some of y'all, Lord, you know what just came to mind. And I don't know if this is just for the men, but it had to be for the women too, because I was thinking about some things. Sean Kingston, beautiful. All these beautiful girls. Okay, girl, don't get distracted. All right, you got things to focus on, fire signs, specifically Leo and Sagittarius. All right, look, I see Mr. Hot Pants. It's actually two Mr. Hot Pants, okay? Knight of Wands is more direct with it. Knight of Cups try to appeal to your heart. Like, you know, you could give me some. It's up to you, though. I'm not forcing you. But imagine what it would be. Like, somebody here trying to talk you into the shit. Like, goodbye. Goodbye. All right, some of y'all need to resist that energy or resist Seven of Wands. Like, nah, nah, girl, nah. Some of y'all, this could be coming from a water sign specifically, a fellow fire sign specifically, but I just feel like this is that energy, okay? It's people that carry this energy. I gotta get out of here because I didn't mean to go this far, all right? Fire signs. That was your Mars and Gemini reading, August 20th until October 29th. Remember, Sun or Mars in a fire sign, all right? Or in the house's first, fifth, and ninth. Like the video, leave a comment telling me if this resonated with you anyway. Subscribe, okay? All pricing and contact information will be in the description box down below. All the info will be in the pinned comment section. All right, I'm about to get up out of here, okay? Peace.